Hello, everybody. My name is Reverend Sung Jae-yeon, the minister at Borneo Park Uniting Church. I welcome you all to join this virtual worship service with the people of Borneo Park. How are we going? As the COVID restrictions and limitations have been eased, are we really moving forward to the next phase in our life and the ministry? We Wallumetta Country Borneo Park Uniting Church will gather together on site this Wednesday to have Ash Wednesday service, and also Sunday, 6th of March, the first face-to-face Sunday worship service since the Christmas service last year. More freedom and easy way to see each other at church is just around the corner. This Sunday worship service will invite us to think about where the love of God lives and where we should bring God's love to. His love is for us and for many, and also His love is found in us and ultimately in Jesus Christ. Let us find God's love in the story of Transfiguration of Jesus.
A Pray for Transfiguration Sunday. Title is, You Come to Us in the Broken Places. God of glory, you took your friends with you when you went to pray on the mountain. You revealed to them the glory of Jesus, your beloved Son, on his way to the cross. We do not live on mountain tops, but we too would glimpse your glory in the ordinary days of our lives and in the community of your Son, in which you have chosen to dwell. We look for you among people who have no power, no right, no voice. We look for you among those who live on the streets of our city, whose housing is inadequate, whose homes are not safe. We look for you among those who grieve a past that is no more and fear a future that seems full of loss. God, who meets us in the broken places, shine the light of Christ deep into our lives, so we may carry that light into dark places and point to the one whose brokenness is our salvation. Amen.
Give thanks to you, O
prayer of adoration. O come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, preaching good tidings to the people, proclaiming release to captives, setting at liberty those who are bound. We adore you. Lord Jesus, friend of the outcast and the poor, feeder of the hungry, healer of the sick. We adore you. Lord Jesus, denouncing the oppressor, exposing the hypocrites, overcoming evil with good. We adore you. Lord Jesus, pattern of gentleness, teacher of holiness, prophet of the kingdom. We adore you. Lord Jesus, dying to save us from our sin, rising to give us eternal life, ascending to prepare our heavenly home. We adore you. Almighty and loving God, you love the world so much that you gave your only Son to be our Savior. You allowed him to empty himself of his heavenly glory and become a suffering servant. Yet by your grace, we have beheld his glory, such glory as befits the Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. Amen.
Today's Bible reading comes from Luke chapter 9, verses 28 to 36. The Transfiguration. About 8 days after Jesus said this, he took Peter, John, and James with him and went up onto a mountain to pray. As he was praying, the appearance of his face changed, and his clothes became as bright as a flash of lightning. Two men, Moses and Elijah, appeared in glorious splendor, talking with Jesus. They spoke about his departure, which he was about to bring to fulfillment at Jerusalem. Peter and his companions were very sleepy, but when they became fully awake, they saw his glory and the two men standing with him. As the men were leaving Jesus, Peter said to him, "Master, it is good for us to be here. Let us put up three shelters, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." He did not know what he was saying. While he was speaking, a cloud appeared and covered them, and they were afraid as they entered the cloud. A voice came from the cloud saying, "This is my Son, whom I have chosen. Listen to him." When the voice had spoken, they found out that Jesus was alone. The disciples kept this to themselves and did not tell anyone at the time what they had seen. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Hi everyone! To our young people at Young at Heart, I just wanted to wish you a wonderful week ahead. I miss you all very much, but I am incredibly excited that we will be able to see each other again soon. For those of you who are at school, uni, work, or all of the above, I am so proud of you. You have all come so far, and it has been a great experience to watch you grow into the amazing people you are today. I'm sure that COVID-19 has changed the way your life works in some way. Maybe you weren't able to meet friends or had to cancel a lot of plans in the last 2 years. Maybe you've been doing online classes for so long that it felt strange to be back at school or a new place altogether. Remember to take the opportunity to talk to someone that you haven't talked to in your class yet, maybe someone you would like to get to know better, and to also learn more about the friends that you already have. It is important to stay connected to one another, especially now. I am sending you all lots of love and praying for you.
As I begin my sermon sharing with you, please bow with me in this prayer. Let us pray. Let's go up the mountain. Let's go up to the place where the land meets the sky, where the earth touches the heavens, to the place of meeting, to the place of meets, to the place of voices and conversations, to the place of listening. O God, we open our eyes and we see Jesus. The month of ministry transfigured to a beam of light. The light of the world, your light. May your light shine upon us. We open our eyes and we see Moses and Elijah, your word restoring us, showing us the way, telling a story, your story, his story, our story. May your words speak to us. We open our eyes and we see mist, the cloud of your presence, which assures us of all we don't know, and that we do not need to fear that. Teach us to trust. We open our eyes and we see Peter's constructions, his best plans, our best plans, our missing the point, our missing the way. Forgive our foolishness and sin. We open our eyes and we see Jesus not casting us off, but leading us down, leading us out to ministry, to people. Your love endures forever. We open our ears and we hear your voice. This is my beloved son. Listen to him. And we give you thanks. Amen. Today, the Saturday, 26th of February, we, the young family, went to a family friend's wedding ceremony. We have a lifelong relationship with the wedding family, who helped a lot when Grace and I raised particularly Joshua and Daniel. Also, we were encouraged by the family always, especially as an overseas student couple. We received material aids and then also pastoral cares and prayers, including the financial donations for our study and also our visa status. For more than 20 years, our relationship has been through all good times and sometimes bad times, but it is true that we are the recipients, Grace and I are the recipients of love, mercy, and grace of the family in Australia. So Grace Jazz Trio contributed musical items for the service of marriage, and our three children and I attended the whole ceremony. To me, the highlight of the ceremony was the first dance, especially when the father of the bride danced with the bride. The father-daughter dance was just a beautiful moment that symbolized their appreciation for the love and guidance they had received throughout their life. In his speech, he had already told his love story towards his daughter that expresses how much he loved and missed his daughter so much, especially while he worked overseas. The father and the daughter began talking to each other while they danced with a slow music. The bride's eyes became teary, and I believe her father's eyes were too. To me, their faces looked shiny, and the wedding dress seemed glittering white. I have known to them since the bride was six. This was the first time ever that her face and his face were so bright like shiny stars. Like Jesus on the mountain and his appearance changed and then surprised his followers, Peter, John, and James. The bride and her father who danced highlighted my understanding of the love that the family and the bride and her father have formed so far, and it transformed many lives like Grace and me and my family. Then he handed over the bride to the groom and let them continue their first dance. He seemed to prepare the time and the space for the groom, stepping down from his role as the prime carer and allowing his son-in-law to take over his role in the new chapters of his daughter, the bride. I believe that he has been up the mountain and is now realizing that he will never stand there again. He has to come down from the role of a little girl's father and face reality, which is his grown-up daughter's future journey that she would create with her husband and discover who she really is. The moment was in a life transition, becoming a person who would have more responsibilities, allowed others to handle matters in life, or prepare the next. So this is the question that I have here. Am I allowing life transitions this moment? In the Transfiguration story, Jesus is fully in sacred but human form. He communicated with Peter, John, James, and God in the heaven in his prayer. He went up with them to the mountain, occupying the space and the time to pray. While he was praying, the appearance of his human face changed and his garments became as bright as a flash of lightning. Jesus prepared God's space to work in him, through him, and allow him to speak to this world. Luke says Moses and Elijah were speaking with Jesus about his departure, which he was about to bring to fulfillment at Jerusalem. Jesus went through the mountaintop experience, knowing that it was preparing him to follow where Moses' law and Elijah's prophecies had pointed. The plain, the valley, the lake and seashore, villages and cities where people suffer and weep, and he himself will be handed over to be crucified. Transfiguration of Jesus is not an end, but a new beginning of his saving and rescuing works in the midst of a whole human history. So God began unpacking his purpose through Jesus, his son. As a sign, the appearance of Jesus' face changed mysteriously. But nothing changes and separates us from the love of God. The transfiguration is a celebration of who Jesus is, the Son of God revealed in human form. So a voice from the clouds says, "This is my son, whom I have chosen. Listen to him." Again, listen to him. The voice speaking from the cloud would have called once again three disciples who were very tired physically and spiritually to go unpack God's mission, among others, then put up shelters for comfortable life. In the Transfiguration story, Jesus reveals himself fully, wholly as human and unveils what God's love looks like. He prepares himself for many lives. As the father of the bride expressed his endless love to her and to his son-in-law, God's love stays always in the midst of his people down here. Not above or somewhere over the rainbow, but in taking care of our family, telling story about the love of God and offering prayers for others, we would know how to understand God's story of everlasting love and his son, only son, Jesus Christ. Then people might see your face shine and find your life full of God's love and mercy. Amen. Recently, Russian invasion to Ukraine has concerned us, threatening the world peace that all human beings have made so far. So now I urge the Australian government to take an action, claiming to Russian government to stop war and this invasion. And also, I gently invite you all to join this prayer, a Lord's Prayer in the time of war. Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, slow to anger and of great mercy, lover of all peoples of the earth. Hallowed be thy name. Remind us that all the nations are as nothing before you, their governments but a shadow of passing age. Thy kingdom come on earth. Grant to thy children throughout the world, and especially to the leaders of the nations, the gift of prayerful thoughts and thoughtful prayer, that following the example of our Lord, we may discern what is right and do it. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Help us to protect and to provide for all who are hungry and homeless, especially those who are deprived of food and shelter, family and friends, by the tragedy of war. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us for neglecting to seek peace and pursue it, and finding ourselves in each new crisis more ready to make war than to make peace. We have not loved thee with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Let us not seek revenge, but reconciliation. Let us not delight in victory, but in justice. Let us not give ourselves up to pride, but to prayer. Lead us not into temptation. Be present to all thy children ravaged by war. Be present to those who are killing and to those who have been killed. Be present to the loved ones of those who are killing and to the loved ones of those who are being killed. Deliver us from evil. Subdue our selfish desires to possess and to dominate, and forbid us arrogance in victory. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. So dear all members of the congregation here at Borneo Park, and also family, friends, and all visitors from all around the world. So we, Borneo Park Uniting Church, is now preparing to have on-site, in-person, face-to-face worship service from this Sunday, the 6th of March. And also this Wednesday, as the Lenten season 2022 begins, We will gather at church to have Ash Wednesday service at 10:30 a.m. This service will include imposition of ashes and Holy Communion. You are welcome. You are more than welcome to join this service. I am looking forward to meeting you all at church and also at our Sunday worship service next coming weeks. So may God bless you all and see you soon.
In the coming week, may you experience the presence of God with joy. May the holy cloud comfort you. May the divine voice encourage you. May the power of the Spirit transform you, transform us, transform our world. Amen. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon us and remain with us always. Amen. See you soon.